The best way to think about cognitive science is that it's a multidisciplinary study of the mind. Because the mind is such a great mystery, we can't really attack it from any single angle. Instead, we have to come at it from lots of different perspectives. That means studying people's behavior as psychologists, trying to create computers that think in artificial intelligence, studying language through linguistics, studying the philosophy of mind, and bringing all of these perspectives together to try and understand the mind better. You know, I came about it in an interesting way, I guess. When I was in college, I took all kinds of different classes. I took some psychology, but I also took computer science, and I took philosophy, and I took anthropology, and I thought they were all amazing. And I wasn't quite sure what I could do with those things. And at some point somebody said, you know, all of these aspects have something to do with people's minds. So maybe you should think about a field called cognitive science. And I looked into that and discovered that I was a cognitive scientist. What would I be doing if I wasn't studying psychology? I guess these days I'd probably be playing the saxophone. About 11 years ago, I took up the sax. I play with a blues band on Sunday nights, and I think that if I wasn't doing psychology and didn't have to worry about making a living, I'd probably be out there trying to play music for fun. Look, all of us have a mind, and all of us are asked to use that mind on a daily basis, and yet almost none of us are taught the way that the mind works. So one of the things that I think is fascinating about psychology is that not only is it just an amazing science to study, but it's something that really can benefit the people who learn about it.